Hi guys, I'm Manas Vichari and welcome back to my channel Astronomy with Manas. So in this video, we'll be going over the concept of supernova and we'll be also predicting how will the star sun in our solar system die. But if you are new to this channel, do subscribe Astronomy with Manas and click on the notification bell. So now many people ask a generalized question, how do stars die? So the simplest answer to this question is stars die because they exhaust their nuclear fuel, collapse, and the outer layer of these stars bursts as a supernova. Supernova? Well, what is a supernova? How does it happen? How does it look like? Will our sun die in the same way or not? So many questions. So in the video ahead, we'll be answering all these questions and making the concept of supernova clear to you. So without any further delay, let's start with the video. A supernova is a powerful and luminous stellar explosion. This transient astronomical event occurs during the last evolutionary stages of a massive star or when a white dwarf is triggered into runaway nuclear fusion. Supernova are more energetic than nova. In Latin, nova means new, referring astronomically to what appears to be a temporary new bright star. Adding the prefix super distinguishes supernova from ordinary nova, which are far less luminous. The word supernova was coined by Walter Paddy and Fritz Zwicky in the year 1929. When one of the stars exhausts its hydrogen, it will enter the red giant stage and then collapse into a white dwarf. The most recent directly observed supernova in the Milky Way was Kepler supernova in 1604, but the remnants of more recent supernova have been found. Observations of supernova in other galaxies suggest they occur in the Milky Way on average about 3 times every century. Now many people ask, can these supernovae be visible to our naked eye? Unfortunately, supernovae visible to the naked eye are rare. One occurs in our galaxy every few hundred years. So there is no guarantee you will ever see one in our galaxy in your lifetime. In 1987, a supernova called 1987A was visible to our naked eye in a nearby galaxy called the Large Magellanic Cloud. Most recently, in a time span of 1 year, the very known star Betelgeuse in the Orion constellation would be a supernova. 1 year to be a supernova means that it will be visible to us after millions of years. Well, how would the supernova look like from Earth? Will it have any effects? Life on Earth will be unharmed. But that doesn't mean it will go unnoticed. Goldberg and Bauer found that when Betelgeuse explodes, it will shine as bright as half the moon, 9 times fainter than the full moon, and for a time span of more than 3 months. This bright spot on the lower left is a supernova SN1994D within its host galaxy NGC 4526. Theoretical studies indicate that most supernovae are triggered by one of the two basic mechanisms. The sudden reignition of nuclear fusion in a degenerate star, or the sudden gravitational collapse of a massive star's core. In the first class of events, the object's temperature is raised enough to trigger runaway nuclear fusion, completely disrupting the star. Possible causes are an accumulation of material from a binary companion through accretion or a stellar merger. Supernovae are also a major source of elements in the interstellar medium, from oxygen to rubidium. Now, how are these supernovae given names? supernova discoveries are reported to the International Astronomical Union's Central Bureau for Astronomical Telegrams, which sends out a circular with the name it assigns to that supernova. The name is formed from the prefix SN, followed by the year of discovery, suffixed with a one or two letter designation. The first 26 supernovae of the year are designated with a capital letter from A to Z. Afterwards, pairs of lowercase letters are used, AA, AB, and so on. Hence, for example, SN 2003C designates the third supernova reported in the year 2003. The last supernova of 2005, SN 2005 NC, was the 367th, that is 14 × 26 + 3. The suffix NC acts as a bijective base 26 encoding, which means A equals 1, B equals 2, C equals 3 till Z equals 26. Since 2000, professionals and amateur astronomers have been finding several hundreds of supernovae each year. For your information, 572 supernovae in 2007, 261 supernovae in 2008, 390 supernovae in 2009, 231 in 2013. There are two main types of supernovae, the type 1 and the type 2. I know this sounds a little counterintuitive, but let's start with type 2 first. These are the supernovae produced when mass stars die. A type 2 supernova occurs in large stars of around 10 solar mass. A type 1 supernova occurs in closed binary systems where two average stars orbit around each other quite closely. And finally, we come to the conclusion how our star Sun in the solar system will die. The simple answer to this question is that it will exhaust its nuclear fuel and the star will collapse and the outer layers will explode as a supernova, just like the other stars. So that's all for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please do share this video with your family and friends so they will also get to know what exactly supernovas are and how will our star Sun die. So, and also subscribe Astronomy with Manas for more such interesting astronomy related videos. If you have any doubts related to this video, please tell them in the comment section. And meet you on next Sunday with another such interesting astronomy video. For then, stay tuned and updated with Astronomy with Manas.